A few months ago, my brother and I bought an iPad for my grandmother. So as you can imagine, she was not really expecting that for her birthday. At first, that iPad stayed in the corner. And then I sat one afternoon with her and started explaining the concept of apps. And the second that she understood that apps were like little shops where she can get information, anything that she wanted, it completely changed. And she started reading books, finding information, finding recipes, watching movies, calling us all the time through the internet. And it completely changed her daily routine. So as you can see on this picture, my grandmother is proudly taking her iPad with her in many places. And she tells me it gave her a sense of confidence and excitement in her life. And this is exactly the point that I find fascinating, how technology can actually change our lives. So as a technologist and as a strategist in mobile and technology, I ask myself many questions, like, what is mobile? What is mobile going to become? What are devices going to look like? But most importantly, what does it mean for us? Will our lives be better or worse? And I strongly believe that if we're able to intelligently address ethical questions such as freedom and privacy, then our lives will be significantly better with the help of new mobile technologies. So today I'm going to focus on three main trends: hyper-personalization, everything mobile, and the connected world. To help us understand the possibilities of today that will drive to the big changes in the next few years. Have you ever felt too overwhelmed with unnecessary information or struggling to find exactly the information that you want on the go? Well, mobile technologies are going to help us solve that problem by filtering and automating information based on our behavior and our location. So, for example, I could get into a shop and be directly guided with my phone to the items that I need based on my previous purchases. I could also pick up an item, like a shampoo, and scan it with my phone. And my phone would be a sort of a lens that would reveal an extra layer of virtual information. So that information could tell me if that shampoo is good for my curly hair. It could tell me what my friends think of that. And it could also give me, for example, a personal discount. So the more we have these mobile phones with us, the more we're able to share data and also to receive data. So which means that the moment that we decide to share that information, we're able to get really tailored information just based on us. So overall, the idea, and we're going to see more and more services like this, it's to get the right information at the right place at the right time. Now, do you think that all of this is going to come from this little box, this little square that we have in our hands all the time? No. It's completely the opposite. Because ultimately, everything could be a mobile. So at this point, I really want all of you to completely open up your mind, set your imagination free, and think of terms of mobility. Because anything could be a mobile. So for example, we already have watches, wristbands, cars, shoes, flexible screens, TVs, or even glasses and lenses. So for example, I could be walking on the street, and I'm meeting with my friends, so my glasses would guide me directly to where they are. And as I'm running a bit late, I would tell my glasses to send them a message with my real-time location so that they know they have to wait for me for a bit. So I think this is just the beginning. Because with all the help of the sensors, our mobile phones will be able to capture much more data about us and our surroundings. So ultimately, our mobile phones will be an extension of us. They will be able to hear, to smell, to touch, to recognize gesture. And this will lead to a completely new experience, which is going to be much more fluid and much more in touch with our physical world. Another very important point is that the hub of information is not going to be on our phones anymore, but it's going to be on the cloud, and we're going to be able to access that information from anywhere. So imagine that devices are like a shell, and that information is like water. And that water can take any shape or form, depending on the device. This also implies that the device itself is going to lose of its importance. It's going to lose value. It's going to be a disposable item. What is going to be really important for us is our digital identity, and to be able to access that information anywhere and in security. So the combination of this hyper-personalized world with all these devices, different devices and sensors, lead us to a connected world. So to help you understand again, I want you to imagine that there's two dimensions that are growing really fast. From one side, we have more people and more things that are connected. So we have people connected through all sorts of devices. We have objects. There are 25 billion objects projected to be connected by 2015. And then we have sensors that help us get information from our surrounding, from nature and our physical world. And all of these things are adding up layers of information, of data, of knowledge. And all of these things are connected. And this creates a giant nervous system of connected information. And with new technologies, it's going to be even easier to process and store that information. So ultimately, that giant system will be able to process, manage, filter, understand information, to be able to deliver us smart, real-time, predictive information. So a morning in this world could look like this. I would wake up, my alarm would be set exactly to my next meeting. It would also tell me exactly how much time I have left to prepare real-time, depending on the traffic. And then as I'm about to leave my house, it will tell me, don't forget your umbrella, because it's predicted to rain in the afternoon. Then I go out, my house locks down by itself, and because I want to be energy efficient, every unnecessary item in my house would shut down and only open up again, like the heating, 1 hour before I come back. So as I'm walking on the street, I get a reminder that in 1 week, it's my grandmother's birthday again. But now she knows how to do a wish list. So in two or three gestures, I'm able to book her favorite holiday. I will let you imagine the rest of that day. I will also let you imagine the number of connections that we're able to do and how much intelligence we can get from that. I will let you imagine what it means for you, for your children, your businesses, your industries, and how much it can change absolutely everything. So we would be in a world where we have all these little agents that are helping us get the right information, filter them, and making our lives easier, healthier, and more energy efficient, and overall reducing wastage. Now, I really think that this is just the tip of the iceberg, and that in the long run, all this mobility and this connectivity can actually solve bigger problems. To conclude, I want to come back into a few points. Mobile is not a device. Mobile is a state of mind. It's a way of living, and we can call it mobility. Technology is not about software, hardware, or apps, or anything. It's about people. It's about making the life of people better and easier. And if it's not, it means that probably it's the wrong technology or we're not using the right way, and we have to work better on it. And finally, change. This change that is going faster and faster should not be taken as a threat. Of course, there are challenges, for sure. So my last request for all of you is to get out of your comfort zone and be open to these new technologies. And take all this change that is happening as an opportunity and embrace all these opportunities. Thank you.